And the news continues at 7:51. Here's a question for you. Does soda consumption lead to behavioral problems in children? Dr. Wendy Rice is a licensed psychologist, and she joins us now on Total Information AM. I have to confess that based on this study in the journal that was reported on in the journal Pediatrics, I am shocked by the amount of soft drinks that young children are drinking these days. They found 43% of kids consumed at least one serving of soft drinks a day, and 4% consumed four or more. And this is five-year-old kids. What did they find as a result of delving into this?
So they were using a pretty large sample of kids, and they had the moms complete behavior rating scales about their kids' behavior. And they found that kids were the three behaviors that were more endorsed by parents whose kids drink one or more cups of soda a day were that they were destroying other people's property more, fighting more, and physically attacking other people more. I mean, physically attacking as in 3-, 4-, and 5-year-olds physically attacking.
Now,
fighting physically.
Do we know if this is possibly caused by the caffeine in the soda or maybe the sugar in the soda? Is there any, do we know exactly what it is about the physiology of soda?
I don't think we do. The other thing that's really important to point out is this study couldn't point to causation. So this study can't conclude that soda causes these aggressive behaviors. All they can say is that it is strongly associated with.
Have there ever been any studies about adults and the consumption of soft drinks? Because I think we all know at least one person who just sits there and all day long drinks soft drinks.
Absolutely. You know, we know that soda, that we know that sugar is an issue. We know preservatives are an issue. We know that caffeine is an issue. And I personally do not know all of what is in soda. I don't know about you guys.
Well, I guess, you know, in my household, my kids, of course, would drink soda all day long if I let them. But it's one of those special occasion things, like if we go out to eat or something. I guess parents who are letting their 5-year-olds have four more sodas a day, they probably drink a lot of soda, too. And so they don't see that it's bad? Do you think that's the reason? I just can't imagine kids in kindergarten just guzzling soda all day long.
I think that is a really big reason, and I also, you know, it makes me question a little bit some of the parenting practices and makes me wonder a little bit about, you know, role models and environments and all that kind of stuff. But they did control in this study for maternal depression, and they did control for, you know, the amount of money that the family made. So, you know, they did their best to try to isolate soda as a factor.
If you can keep your children from starting on soda at a young age, that's a good thing. And if they're on soda and they're drinking a lot, cut them back and see if you can't get them off it.
I don't really know that there is a negative to seltzer or Perrier. Not that you really want your 4-year-old to drink Perrier. But, you know, if the kids crave the bubbles and they love the bubbles, then use club soda and put a little cranberry juice in it or put a little orange juice in it or do something to make it special. If, you know, and that may just be a good strategy for helping to wean your kids off.
All right. Thanks for the information this morning. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Dr. Wendy Rice is a licensed psychologist.